speaking with Jonathan Downs this morning from Kaiser Reef. Jonathan, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very good. Good to be speaking with you. You've had your March quarterly report out in the last couple of days here. Just firstly, from a production perspective, run us through some of the main highlights.
Sure. It's been a very active quarter as usual, and it has been less focused on actual production than it has been on gearing up to expanded production, and that has impacted a little bit of what we've been, from a production perspective. Nevertheless, it was a pretty healthy quarter. Our cash balance rose despite very heavy investment in both time and funds into the ramp up.
Well, tell us more about these ramp up plans for production.
Sure. So in about September, we had a really fabulous quarter, and it showed the high margin potential for this mine, which I believe is Australia's highest grade operating gold mine at the moment. And we realized at that point that we were hitting a production limit on what our infrastructure was allowing us to mine. And we did an investigation into what bottlenecks there were, and the primary one was a power restriction. So we commenced a high voltage power upgrade, which involved putting a lot of deep cables, very big cables, to really open up the long-term potential for the mine through specific infrastructure drill holes. As usual, these kind of things take a lot longer than you imagine when you commence the work, and cost a lot more. And we then installed some surface infrastructure, generators, those sort of things, which are now being commissioned. And that allows us to improve our ventilation, our mining capacity rate, and a whole bunch of other things that are necessary for expanded production. And I'm pretty pleased to say that we are only a few weeks away now from what I would consider quite a radical change in our production rate. And the beauty with our operation here is that most of our costs are fixed. So, I'm hoping, and the plan is for a better margin along with greater revenues. And we had pretty good revenues last quarter of $9.5 million. Not bad for a company with a market cap of about $25 million. And we actually generated a reasonable margin there. We also conducted various other infrastructure upgrades at the processing plant too. We replaced our mill liners, which were an albatross around our neck, in that the mill liners were always consuming quite a large percentage of our gold, and we were every quarter forced to do a bit of a clean out. I'm very pleased to say that the new engineered liners are unlikely to hold up any gold. So that in conjunction with a logic control upgrade has seen an increase in production rate, and the mill should also be on a good footing to cope with higher production rates.
Have you put any numbers out into the market in terms of what this additional infrastructure will allow in terms of a ramp up and expanded production?
Sure. Without formal JORC reserves, I have to be cautious about any future projections. But I can say that the infrastructure upgrade will facilitate more than double production rates as an opportunity for us to work with. And it's all very well just to double your production rate, but one of the big investment points for us has been a lot of development underground to get all the extra working faces ready to deliver that ore as well, including the odd extra bit of mining fleet as well.
And from an exploration perspective, you've been looking for extensions to the A1 mine, have you?
Yes. Prior to making all these investments into the future of the A1, we did do some deep drilling, and I'm very pleased to say we've encountered mineralization as far as where we've pretty much drilled. I think one of the more recent deep drill holes is returned 1.5 ounces per ton of gold, So we're very confident that the ore body continues at depth, pretty much in line with where it's been historically. And just to be clear, at this stage, we're still remnant mining. We're still mining what other people left behind. In the not too distant future, we'll be reaching the mining limits of the old timers, and we'll then start to have what we call the virgin ore, which will be, we believe, substantially higher grade and more of it than the material we've had access to currently.
And Jonathan, what have you been doing as far as the Malden Gold Project?
So Malden has been, it's had a lot of work put into it. It's looking much tidier than it used to. It's running at a higher run rate. It's got more capacity. It's an operation we're very proud of now. And over the quarter, we went to quite a lot of effort to get these engineered liners. Again, took a little longer to get installed. The logic control upgrade has improved the stability and increased our hourly throughput rate substantially just through early trials. We're still running at well below capacity. So our dream is one day we'll get the Malden Goldfield back into production as well. We had a license granted that surrounds that license and allows us to step out, and it facilitates the deeper drilling underneath it. And that's very exciting. So the team's planning the drilling for Malden. And one day it's our hope to have a second mine come on. And importantly, it's fully permitted. It's ventilated. We replaced the 300 meters of ventilation bagging underground over the quarter. And it's got electricity down there and a deep decline. So a lot of the work's been done. We've just got to do a lot more drilling, prove up some resources and reserves, and get cracking there.
Well, look, across the portfolio, looking ahead, Jonathan, what are the near-term key milestones for you?
Well, probably the number one for us is to deliver on our hope to increase our production at A1 and really start seeing what the potential of the A1 mine is. It is a very unusual mine. It's been running since 1861. It's very high grade, and I believe we've invested what we need to now to really give it a good shake. So that's probably our number one. We have exploration drill rigs going. During last quarter, we delivered a 2,000 gram ton intercept, which I think calculated out to over 500 gram meters. And interestingly, I do get people questioning, are narrow veins economic? Is something below, for example, 50 centimeters, is that economic? And it really comes down to the metal that's contained in it. So in our case, we hit 25 centimeters at 2,000 grams a ton. That's 500 gram meters. That's exactly the same metal as 500 meters at 1 gram. And from a mining and processing perspective, you actually want it in a condensed possible a block as possible. So yes, it's absolutely economic to be mining 1 centimeter wide loads if that's got the metal in it. And the nature of our ore body is narrow vein, but very, very high grade. And this last quarter, we delivered and processed 17.3 grams per ton gold over the quarter. So long term, we're probably running at around 12 grams over the past year. So it's a fascinating mine, and it's a little bit different.
Well, that's interesting. What you said a bit earlier. In the quarter, revenues around 9.5 million, a market cap of 25 plus or minus, a very high grade project here with the A1 mine. Why would you encourage investors to take a closer look at Kaiser Reef?
Well, from my personal opinion, I think adding to your list of inventory, we also own our own mill, we own our own fleet, and we own the 2 million ounce, 28 gram a ton historic Malden Goldfield. So as a value proposition, I think it does seem unreasonably cheap. Adding to that, we are profitable. We're making money, and I guess we need to prove we can make more money and really ramp up the operation. So I'm confident that that's where we're heading. Perhaps a little more marketing is required. I think the market is now open-minded towards gold juniors. It was a pretty tough time over the past year or so, and I have a feeling that now that the Australian gold price is over $3,000 an ounce, that we're in for a good time.
Let's hope so. Jonathan, good to see you. Thanks very much.
Right. Thank you, Andrew. Bye-bye.